Hello YouTube, it's Grossama, and here we have today is the SD Cross Silhouette Zeta Gundam. Now, this is a mobile suit that I am truly in love with. I love everything about it, the aesthetics, even the transformation I think looks really good. I think the only few transformations that I think is superior than this one would be the Age 2 Gundam mobile suits. But this one just has a really nice sleek aesthetic. I think it looks pretty cool. Almost something I would, you know, really consider to be put in its, you know, alternative transformation mode, vice its MS mode at times, because I think it looks that good. However, the SD Cross Silhouette does not transform whatsoever. Now, obviously, with some, you know, nice little modeling skills that you might have, you could definitely go ahead and make this into a transformable mobile suit. I think I've definitely seen some pictures on Twitter or Instagram of it being transformed when it actually got first released, because some guys, you know, definitely went ahead and customized it to the best of their abilities. But we're here pretty much to go ahead and look over the SD Gundam. Right now it is in its cross silhouette mode, but we're gonna go ahead and take a look at the SD portion first, and then we'll move over to the cross silhouette. So let's go ahead and take a look. Okay, so let's take a look at the SD form. The SD form has, you know, basically the default frame that comes with the kit, and when compared to a lot of other SDs, there's definitely going to be a bigger proportion on just this form itself without the cross silhouette form. Now, taking a look at the details and overall aesthetics, I think this kit looks pretty damn good. There's really not much in terms of like heavy details like panel lines and all that, but what you do get is still something to be amazed about when it comes to the SD line. The only big key feature that we're missing here is the pretty much like the separation of color parts. A lot of it's still going to be in that like very bulk color like white or black, but you do get some stickers to go ahead and utilize for this kit. So when looking at the stickers, you are going to have a lot of this red, which is primarily going to be for the backpack. You do have the, you know, eye stickers, which are right on there. I went ahead and just put that on there. There's no raised parts, so this is all going to be a blank slate. Now, you do have this green, which is going to be for the cross silhouette mode, which is a white piece, but it's only a white piece that you can color. So you can color it green, and you will not you won't have any need for this green sticker. Then you have some of the little cameras right here on the top of the head, and then you have some parts right here for like the thrusters. Overall, a lot of this can easily be painted. So if you do have some like maybe primer, throw down some primer, and then just go ahead and hand paint that red if you really want to. Okay, so let's take a look at the articulation of the kit. The head is essentially going to be on like a little ball joint and can go back and forth like that. The shoulder is also on a ball joint, so it can definitely move around quite a bit, but mine's a little bit loose only because I've been messing around with it and kind of pulling it in and out of CS mode, but yours should be pretty much fine. Inside here is also going to be on a ball joint, but it's not as going to be, it's not going to have as much of a range of movement as the shoulder, so you're really going to be limited into what kind of pose you can go ahead and pull off with it. But if you kind of just move it around, you can definitely at least get the forearm like that, and then kind of bring it back to where the inside of the little like forearm and bicep is going to be showing. Hand is on a ball joint as well. So the red cockpit right here can actually come up as well. It has like its own little kind of like swivel movement, but it doesn't really do anything in terms of like transformation, so I don't really know what the point of that is, and I don't think they really address it, so it's kind of just like a wasted little feature. Waist goes back and forth. These side skirts are also going to be on these little pegs that can pretty much move back and forth. Now, the legs are also going to be on ball joints, but they are very limited in movement. They can basically go about that much, and they do fall off a little bit easily, more easily than what the Nightingale did, so I would just say beware of that. Maybe you gotta put a little glue around that joint just to go ahead and keep it intact. The ankle skirt goes up and down, and then the foot is also going to be on a little ball joint. Now for the backpack, these little binders right here are just on little pegs, so they can move back and forth. And then this little thruster slash like stabilizer can go up about that much. Now, as far as accessories, you're really not going to get much outside of the beam rifle and the shield, as well as a beam saber. But I do not have the beam saber, so I'm just going to let y'all know, I basically lost it. It looks exactly like this, just a little bit smaller. It's an all white piece. That's pretty much about it. So you would have to paint the beam itself as well as the hilt, or you can leave the hilt white on it, but you definitely have to paint the beam effect part. But I'll go ahead and I'll let y'all know, and I'll let y'all in on something a little bit later on. So overall, the beam rifle does look pretty good. It's going to be one solid piece, so you know, you just cut it right out of the runner. And overall, I mean, I think it looks really good. It's a little bit right here too big for the hand. So whenever you slide in and out, it seems that it's kind of like messing up the plastic. So you may have to shave this down just a little bit to get, you know, have a better ease of access into the hand, as well as not scratching the paint both on the rifle and inside the hand. But there's definitely going to be a lot of parts where you can go ahead and paint. So you want to paint like the on top of here, the little muzzle right here. I mean, wherever you want to. I'm probably gonna paint quite a few bits on here just to kind of, like, you know, give it a little bit extra resin detail. And here's the other accessory, which is basically going to be the shield. It's three parts in total. You got two parts for the red, and you got one part right here for the black. And the peg right here just connects right there into the forearm. I think overall it looks pretty good. I'm very happy they went ahead and got this pretty much separating color, so you don't really have to like paint all this red, or you know, it having like a red sticker or black sticker or whatever. So the color separation does look pretty good, and there's still some little details right inside here if you can go ahead and see that. So definitely some opportunities for panel lining or just you know, painting it in general. So with the accessories equipped, I think overall it looks really good. When it's in SSD mode, you're really not going to get that posability that you're probably going to be looking for. But I don't know how people are when it comes to the SD line. Like me personally, I don't really like it, but I love the cross silhouette because of the cross silhouette frame. So when I'm looking at this as just a SD form, I'm not really that impressed, because I feel as if you can't really do too much unless you kind of like start modding it. But at that point, I mean, you're really doing something that's not of like the SD line. The SD as just the base standard, I'm just always not impressed with it, just because it's just something that stands, or you can put it on a stand, and then it kind of looks like it's flying. But sometimes the feet don't really have great articulation, and it just kind of looks like it's just floating, and that's it. But yeah, I think with the accessories on here, it does look pretty good overall. Okay, so since I am missing the beam saber that originally comes with this kit, I have so many other beam sabers in my collection, so I just took something from my little high grade beam sabers, that, like, I have a little bag that has none but high grade beam sabers in it, and I just went ahead and borrowed one. I don't know exactly which one this one came from. I think this is a one of my RX-78s, so I think overall it looks way better with an actual beam effect part than just like you coloring it. Now, obviously, if you're a good painter, you can definitely make it look pretty good. But if you're going to keep it as very simple as you can, then definitely go ahead and just grab a beam saber, you know, from one of your high grade kits if you have it. If not, I mean, maybe ask someone if they have an extra one, or, you know, maybe buy a high grade and kind of just, you know, use the extra one that comes with it, since a lot of times these high grades do come with extra beam saber effect parts. Okay, so now that it's in its cross silhouette mode, just the major differences I'm going to go ahead and point out, because it's really not too much. It's mostly in the limbs. Now with the head, you do have like this more like real type Gundam eyes. So instead of using the little like cartoonish stickers for the other side, you're just going to go ahead and keep these as parts. Now there are stickers for these if you want to go ahead and utilize them, but I mainly just went ahead and just kept like is, because I am going to be painting it. Now the body did change, so essentially what happens is now, instead of these shoulders being fixed, the shoulders on the inside, if I can go ahead and I'll try and take the head off, but the shoulders on the inside right here, they actually plug in and out. Now this is pretty much all cross silhouette frames, and it just basically allows more of a kind of like posability. So instead of it being like really close on the torso area, it basically has more room at like pretty much a wider range for posability, which I think is pretty damn cool. So now looking at the arms, the major thing is going to be the range of mobility. So this is the SD form right here. This doesn't have any kind of bend on the elbow region. The shoulders are pretty much the same. I don't think there's really much difference between this one and this one. But aside from that, this is going to be able to have that nice little posability, little bit of articulation right there in the elbow, which makes a huge difference. I mean, whenever you're doing poses, you can definitely pull off more dynamic stuff with these, vice the one that's just in a fixed pose. And for the waist, the major thing about the waist is going to be these little parts. So you see like right here, it has these two little pegs. This basically allows the feet just to peg right inside there, and that's it. And they kind of move around just a little bit. Now with these, they are replaced with ball joints. So you can go ahead and plug this part directly on top of the ball joint like so, which is gonna give it a little bit more range of movement. And then with the legs, basically the legs are extended and they are gonna have pretty much a little bit of mobility right here at the knee, which is more top of the thigh, to be honest. But this is gonna be the solid piece for the SD form. So this is definitely gonna be a lot better because you're gonna go ahead and extend the overall height of the mobile suit and you have a bit more of articulation overall, even with the feet as well as right up here. So this can basically like swerve around and this is gonna have that little bend as you can see. So in conclusion, I think this kit is pretty damn cool. It's one of those like SDs that I always wanted, but the fact that they never got the proportions right on some of the older SD kits, that just kind of drew me away from it. But this one, like, I'm just super happy for it. Like, they took away the transformation, which to me is a pro. A lot of people may like it, but I really just wanted it to be a normal like robot mode SD. So going over some of the pros of the kit, I think the overall color separation really is not bad. The main part is going to be on the backpack with a lot of that red, but hey, the head itself I think is pretty awesome. The way they separate the eyes, now this is just a pretty much a standard when it comes to the cross silhouette line, but you know, a limited amount of stickers is pretty much what you're really going to need because the rest can easily be painted, some of the yellow and black and so on. But yeah, that's pretty much like my biggest pros on this kit is like the color separation is really awesome. The proportions are really good. I wish like maybe the joints were a little bit better, but you know, once again, it's the cross silhouette line. So you really need to pick and choose what you would love. Maybe in the future we'll have a much better SD line with like very, very limited stickers and so on and so forth. But you know, I'm kind of like accepting of what it is right now, and I'll put forth the effort to go ahead and paint my kits. So my final thoughts on this kit, essentially to summarize it, this kit is pretty damn cool. Even without all the stickers that you see, it doesn't have anything on it right now, so I think it looks pretty awesome even without the stickers. But if you went ahead and put forth a little bit of effort and just paint some of the the stickers, paint the extra little details, I think that's really going to go a long way, and it's going to make you appreciate the SD cross silhouette line just a little bit more, and you'll be more proud to actually display it on your shelf. Vice keeping it very, very simple and with bare minimum efforts as far as like just using the stickers and maybe a little bit of panel lining. I would definitely encourage y'all to go ahead and put forth a little bit of effort just for the paint, because I know like the thrusters and such doesn't have any good color separation. So I would just ask you if you can pick up a little bit of paint and just paint in those details, and a little bit of that practice is definitely gonna go a long way, and it might actually motivate you to really start picking up a little bit more on painting skills. But that's just it for me, guys. I just want to go ahead and express that. So I definitely appreciate y'all for watching this review all the way to the end. And like always, definitely subscribe, like the video if you can, and then just stay tuned for my next reviews. All right, guys, I'll see y'all later. Bye-bye.